Oh!
Oof.
Move! Oh. There we go, boys. We did it. Anybody get some? You did? Holy shit! AR came first, bro, dude. Oh, I got something better. Wait, I need the arcane! I just got sniped. Well, I need the arcane. It's great for PKing, bro. You're practicing your PKing skills. He's further and further with every second. Tension, you know, it's like a rubber band slingshot effect. Where's your character going?
What the?
Oh my god,
Dude, this
dude.
game is so broken, I love it. Dude, I declawed from like China there.
Yo, guys, I found a really good raid. I can't wait to show you guys. Let's go inside. You guys know about Raid Shadow Legends, the mobile RPG done right? It is nominated as a finalist for Google Play's Best of 2019 User's Choice Award. Raid has over 400 champions for you to collect, discover 13 spectacular locations, enjoy a fully voiced story campaign, and the best part, it is free to play. You can find the game here. Here's some solid features that'll suit your taste. Multi-battle auto mode, just like AFK skilling in RuneScape. Weekly tournaments and events to help your gameplay and keep you busy. There are huge updates in the game for over 6 months. Here's a roadmap for these updates. Are you ready to play Raid Shadow Legends? Check out the video description, click on the special link so you can earn 100,000 silver, 1 energy refill, 50 gems, and 1 free champion, the Executioner. You can find all these rewards on the top right of the game screen, located here. Look at this slick champion that you get for free. These rewards are incredibly useful, but there's only 30 days to grab them. Good luck and have fun. Alright, just hit 9 wood cutting. I've been waiting for this, dude. Willows are not bad. They're pretty good XP, dude. I've been chilling, you know, AFKing at about 200k an hour. But, dude, Redwoods, I'm not exactly sure what it's like. I've never used Rune Axe at Redwoods, but it's going to be so much more AFK, you know, when I need to do some editing and stuff. Alright, I've been AFKing Redwoods with the Rune Axe now for a little bit over an hour. At this rate, it'll take me like 35 hours to get 99 wood cutting. I think I will go for it just for the points, and also I can get Bird's Nest for future raids. For those super fast raids, I would love to be able to use Brews. Holy shit. I'm loving the Chrono Plant, dude. So good for farming experience, because like all my XP comes from the trees. And yeah, thanks to Chrono, my Redwood tree grew like a day in advance or two. Alright guys, I am super excited for this Redwood, man. I think this is a big task too, right? On top of the experience, oh my god, let's do this. Oh, baby. Whoa. Yo, that's some crazy shit. Chronos is overpowered. I literally just planted this, like, in the same clip. Alright, first level in my next skilling plans. I'm gonna try to get to base 60s when I'm not AFKing. 3 skills, not in the 60s yet. Hunter, runecrafting, is that it? Actually, that's just those two, I guess. Yeah. Hey, 60 hunter? Nice. Nice, dude. This guy has a DFS! Honestly, more rare than a third age piece, honestly. Yes, there it is, 93 Slayer. Smoke Devils, hell yeah. Can't do it though. 2 more levels to go for the 95. Let's get it. There it is, 77 Smithing. Alright. So we got some big plans, you know, to our gear setup. I'm gonna be bringing knives, I think, from now on. Just cause they're insane. I've never shown you the one tick knives, but if you guys have seen it before, you know what's up. The DPS potential on these knives is actually insane, because it's one tick faster, which means it's exactly one tick throws. These are basically 100% more damage than the main game. So alright, so here's our latest setup concoction here. So our specialty now is the knives, right? But yeah, the range accuracy isn't too bad. I mean, the knives on its own is really bad, but my base accuracy is really good. You can also thank the buckler. That's like, you know, an extra 20 plus percent accuracy increase on my setup. What I'm about to show you is some of the craziest shit you'll ever see on RuneScape in general, okay? So drill this into your brain. just imagine a weapon that can attack every 0.6 seconds. So just imagine half a second, you're just hitting crazy. All right, so for visual, a blowpipe attacks every 2 ticks, right? So that's 1.2 seconds. Now with Zerg's focus, I can turn a 2-tick weapon into a 1-tick weapon, right? Because everything that I use is 1-tick faster. So, knives, they are 2-ticks originally, but because 1-tick reduction, it is now 1-tick weapon. So basically, the faster weapons gain a crazier DPS increase with the Zerg's focus, and of course, the knives gain the most benefit because I just basically doubled its power. Because it's attacking twice as fast, right? Simple math, just double the power. And look at this power. It's disgusting. It is basically the strongest DPS on things that are low range defense. And at raids, there's two good rooms for that. There is the Agility room, the Majors, and even the Rangers. They have like very low defense, so the knives destroy them. And also a Mutadal room, very low defense, so the knives destroy them as well. There is one big weakness though. In order to shoot every 0.6 seconds, I have to stand still. That means I can't move around with it or else I lose half the DPS power. Which means I can't really use it on the head phase of Ulm, because I have to move all the time. Yep, he tried to flame me again. But I got him good. With that duck. Okay, I'm gonna trust my claws this time. Woo! It was good. I was confident I was gonna be able to pull that one off. Shit. That was a really good acid run though. Probably my best one. Ooh, what the fuck? I just got 94 wood cutting. Got it. Ooh, we got it! Yo, boys! It happened, dude. Holy shit, the second Onyx. Let's go. Let's freaking go, man. That's awesome. Alright, yeah, man. Looks like I'm gonna AFK train my ass to 90 crafting as soon as I possibly can, dude. Alright, so now that I have my second Onyx, it means I don't have to focus so much on trying to do Tecton only raids. I can do other stuff, you know? We can go for layouts like Mutadial with Shamans and Skeletons and something like that. Those are really good raids. Those are really fast. So yeah, now I should be able to get into raids a bit faster because I don't have to be so picky. Alright, so I need 5.3 mil for 90. So that means 1.9 mil experience to 90 crafting for the Fury, right? Okay, so just based off the silver ores alone, that should get me there. But I actually have gems again. yeah. Before the tiaras again, I'm gonna cut the gems for sure. Okay, pretty much done cutting all the gems, and the total experience gain was 925k, so that helps so much. The last two levels are going to be pretty slow, even with a 5x, you know, base rate. Alright, so I'm pretty broke. I got like 20k in my bank, but I've saved up on a ton of random alks, so let me see what I got right now that I can get out of. Ooh, about 4 mil? That's good. I got a lot more in the bank, so 4 mil should last me quite a while. Oh, I just got base 50s. Oh, shit. Alright, guys, it is time to get the base 60s out of the way. There it is. 60 runecrafting. Hey. So, I gained quite a bit of points. I'm, like, being etched out of the dragon ring. Gonna hit up mining. Gonna get that 80. Probably get smithing to 80 as well. That'd be good. There's a lot of points there as well in tasks and obviously the 80 base, so go for that next. And 2,000 total coming up, so should be a lot of points for that. Holy shit, finally. This is the layout that I can do now because, yeah, we're not so fixated on Tectons anymore. It's a good layout, really, really fast. Mutadal start, you know, Shamans finally. Get to see some Shaman action again with the anti-poison. No! Yes! Yes! Oh shit, Zenites. Fuck, of course. Zenites, right? In Tisselique. Ah, doesn't exist. One more level to go, though. One more level. 500k, goddamn. Alright. I can taste it almost. Alright, guys. After a long, long session of crafting, as you can see here, I've gained over 760,000 experience, and finally, we have reached it, pretty much. Alright. Come on now, pull through. Yes, right there. 90 crafting. Imagine having to actually get the real level for the crafting. No boosting available in the Twisted League. Members can now craft Onyx amulets. Yes! Let's freaking... Wait. I want to make sure we're not making a berserker necklace and none of that. Okay. Alright, we're good. I will cry if I made the wrong thing. Yes. And string it. Yes. And the enchant. Oh, brothers. Brothers and sisters and helicopters. Boys. It is done. I've never been so excited for Fury. Not since the first time I made one on Mr. Ironbar years back. And the prayer bonus is nice too. 2 prayer bonus extra and 2 strain bonus extra. So that's good. I might be able to get an extra max out of my whip at my current gear. We'll see. I'll be looking forward to hitting a 40, 41 if possible. But yeah, man, this is sick, dude. Really pimped out on jewelry. We have the best jewelry pretty much available in Twisted League. Straight up, like, there is nothing better. Yeah, I'm pretty sure there's nothing better. Holy shit, dude. Beautiful, guys. So let's quickly recap on what's going on with Twisted League goals-wise. Originally, I wanted to just try to do soul raids in Twisted League so I can get a purple. We did that a while ago, so I decided to continue the series further because I'm just having so much fun. But I think the ultimate goal is to do challenge mode raids and hopefully get a metamorphic dust. So the dust allows me to transmog my Alma into any of the other raids bosses, and the pets in the league system are permanent in the sense that they transfer over to the future league. So it's totally worth it. That's the one thing other than my rank that actually gets to stay, that I get to keep. Everything else I've gone, you know, will get deleted. So the dust would be such a worthwhile endgame goal. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. Happy early Christmas to those of you guys that celebrate. And all I ask, I guess, for Christmas from y'all is simply like the video. If you guys enjoy the video, hit the video up with a like. Let me know that I'm doing a good job. And of course, make sure to subscribe and ring the bell so you don't miss out on the next video. The next video is going to be really good, I promise. Alright guys, I'll see y'all later. Bye bye.